My name is Rhapsody and welcome back to Enter the Gungeon. I think I must have by this point killed enough to finish this quest, god damn it! What do you say, Rifle? Still hunting. Three more shambling rounds. Alrighty then, alrighty Teddy, let's go get him. I mean, hell, I want him to appear in my run. I want every room to just be two shambling rounds, because I could take that on and get mad rich, and then... yes, then, we would be incredibly powerful. Hang on one second here as I unplug that, just in case it happened to interfere with my control schema. Damn it! I hate when this kind of thing happens directly after I start an episode. It was just a controller that I had plugged in, and I don't want it to suddenly act up in some fashion or a fly to land on it and make me shoot in the wrong direction, and then I have to explain that, and ugh. A horrible situation all around. Alright. Got him. Just specifically trying to keep that water barrel over the other side alive here. Not for much more than the sake of possibly needing it when I might have to open a thing later. Whee! The path to the oubliette. You can't always save the water barrel in that room. Sometimes it just gets insta-killed. Nothing you can do about it occasionally. This gives us options. Alright. It's funny to think, when this game came out and when the oubliette was, you know, newly discovered. In fact, I think for like the first couple months of this game's existence. Full release. There was a period of time where the water barrel didn't appear in the room with the entrance to the oubliette. If you start a new save file, it won't. But after you first unlock the oubliette, the water barrel will start appearing in the room with the fireplace, just so that you can kind of do it hassle-free. Ooh, I want both of those. The point I'm trying to make here is if that wasn't in the same room, would I bother, even half as often as I do, to go down to the oubliette? Just putting that slight obstacle in the way might stop me from going to the oubliette in upwards of 50% of cases. It's a tiny, tiny change, and really, it's not like a big strategic or tactical change. It is a quality of life kind of change. But it makes a huge impact in the way that I play and progress through the game. Now that's a super easy one to think about. Are there any others that are great examples in this game? Not that I can immediately think of. But of course, the fact that they're subconscious means it's very unlikely that I would be able to immediately think of them. They're not easily identifiable because they're not something that I've been consciously thinking about. Hence, subconscious. Okay, hang on. Alright, he's not doing any bow wow wow kind of stuff. So, I don't know. That's probably not a mimic, which means I'm probably not going to spend a key to get in there. Two keys for a blue chest, especially when I constantly ignore blue chests when I'm low on keys. That seems like a bad value proposition for me. Okay. You stay there, and beauty. Do you want to keep this Guan Stone kicking about as long as I can? Beauty. Okay, that just looked a little suspect, but we should be fine. Sure. Ah, that's exactly what I was thought was going to happen. No! I didn't think you were going to jump again! In fact, I don't think I've seen you ever do that specifically before. Jump to a location and then immediately jump away. Yeah, that's my fault. I turned around because I wanted to knock down the chandelier. And that moment's focus that I took away from the Gatling Gull, I got hit. Entirely my fault. That one's also my fault for rolling way too early. Man, this boss is so much easier with a speed up. Not that it's difficult by nature. I mean, if I got hit once, I may as well get hit a bunch of times here. It really doesn't matter. Grumble, grumble, grumble. I did it to myself, I'm more than well aware. Don't worry. Okay. Let's go find us some secret rooms. Alright then. Nothing doing. Two blue chests, no key drops. This is not looking very, very enticing here. Even if we did have the HP up from the boss, this still wouldn't be great. I mean, obviously, that doesn't downplay the fact that I lost the master round from the boss there, but still. I have to make some statements to make myself feel better about it. Interestingly, that actually finally proves something that I wanted to see proven for a while, which is enemies take more damage when they're standing in the flames than when they're standing out of the flames. That seems like a really arbitrary point to make, but it's not, because are the flames on the ground just a way of inflaming the enemy? Because if it is, then an enemy on fire should take the same amount of damage regardless of where they're standing, whether they're standing in the fire or out of the fire. But the enemies in the fire died first, so there's also an aspect of damage that comes from being on fire as well as being in the fire. I actually don't think I can open this. I'm glad to have 60. Don't get me wrong, I'm really glad to have 60 because it means I can take one thing and a key. And it's definitely going to be scope. Okay, I'll open this. I regret it! This is why I didn't want to open it! I knew I'd get this item specifically. Alright then. Well, they're a lot more accurate. Still not that good though. That's still rough as hell. It's a little bit better, I guess. Alright, we're probably gonna start using the Moonscraper. Although I will be using the Moonscraper against this boss, so I probably don't want to use the Moonscraper until after the boss on this floor. Only off the back of having the accuracy up would I ever start using the shotgun here. Oh, I knew the secret room was here, and that's why I took damage. Because I knew it was going to give me armor back anyway, I guess? I would never have found that there, so no harm, no foul, right? Rude. This room is more difficult than it looks just because there's another enemy on the other side. Ugh. Alright, we need to start playing better. Hey. I could go back to using the basic... the basic weapon, but I really don't want to. For one thing, it doesn't one-cycle these. I mean, apparently my basic, apparently this gun doesn't either, but weird, it did before. I guess maybe I didn't reload before I came into this room. I typically just automatically do that at the end of every room. Well, I mean, we will be taking the key there, but that's about it. I should have blanked the shop last floor. I didn't even think about it. This is just tilt interfering with my play. Beautiful. Not getting an incredible amount of money from the signature enemies, but that's fine. We got exactly as much as we needed last floor, and that's okay. Well, we're officially out of blanks. This enemy is nowhere near deceased. Until now, beautiful. Sorry, I had to focus there for a second because I can't lose this one as well. Because then I get Mind Flayer next floor, and then I get High Priest the floor after, and I never get a master round. Okay. Let's go back to using this as a weapon. Fine, nothing in there. Did have to use both of my blanks, but that's okay. Let's hold off on spending any of our money until we get a special shop, so that we can guarantee that we're getting the most bang for our buck, quite literally, in fact. Oh, speaking of bang for your buck, Winchester's challenge is definitely up there. Pretty much guaranteed black or gold. Black or red chest, rather. Okay, never mind. A guaranteed green chest. Don't mind if I do. God, I'm bad at this one. I managed to perfect it last time, but that was fluke. Rude. Alright, it's harsh is the easiest one to do here, right? Nope. Oh, a Gungeon pep! That could scarcely have gone worse. I'm real bad at that specific one. And then, not only that, but I got fucked over on it as well. It gave me a worse version of it. In that a shot that would have connected just didn't connect because the moving head was just slightly out of position. I shot the exact same shot again and it hit. Rude. Okay, nanomachines is actually going to be really helpful. It'll help me keep up a lot of the life that otherwise it looks like I would be unable to keep to myself. That should be pretty much everything interesting on this floor. Yep, looks about it. All right, let's go take our other greenie and get out of here. And the key from the shop. We already found the secret room. I don't know why I kept checking. Well, I mean, there can be two secret rooms. Eh, but a break at 47's fine. Its ammo count leaves a lot to be desired, but against certain bosses, it'll be an absolute gem. So what do I use for the next floor? I think it might be Mac. Beautiful. It should be Mac just because of the ammo count, to be honest. There we go. Other than Mac and maybe Moonscraper, I don't think any of these guns would really make it a long enough way to be efficient for traversal of the floor. This does leave a little to be desired in terms of damage, though. And the accuracy isn't amazing. Thankfully, I have the scope. Alright, looks like we're gonna go straight in, vertebrae. That was really unfortunate that it put down the grenade directly next to me. Ugh. Because it put it in a position and then destroyed my only kind of retreat from it. So I was guaranteed to have to blank. And in a fight that is probably going to be quite long and protracted, losing a blank at the very start is a little rough. Moonscraper. It's just so I can stay at whatever range I like. Beauty. Not the easiest, but not the worst treadnought I've ever had. Science cannon. See, this is why I'm still forcing out the weapons, because we aren't really getting the luck of the draw here. Science cannon, however, being a green tier weapon, is going to be one of the first things that I feed into a gun muncher. So I'll start using science cannon as my room clear. You can kind of see why I don't like it. We've been firing it the entire time I've been in this room, and we only just killed an enemy. Okay. Sniper rifle's pretty good. It could be handy. Oh, you know what is actually a really cool idea? Okay, hang on. For a game design kind of thing, for Gungeon. So there should be a gun in the game that is really bad, but it has a synergy with a bunch of different passive items. The point being, like, it's kind of like a modular gun. You just keep adding things to it and it becomes better and better. Like, with one synergy, it's a reasonable gun, and then with two of the synergy items, it's a much better gun. With three of them, it's ridiculous, and then you can just keep building from there. I was thinking, just because I was thinking, oh, why isn't there a synergy for the sniper rifle and the scope? Oh, and then there could be one for, like, a barrel, like a muzzler, and the sniper rifle. Oh, and then there could just be everything else on the sniper rifle, and you can build a ridiculously buff weapon kind of piecemeal. That would be really cool. That would make for some really interesting runs. And that's what I like most about guns in this game. The guns and synergies and weapons, passives. The things that make for a really, really interesting variant on the typical playstyle. They don't have to be incredibly common that they come up, but when they do, boy, they are good. Like the old muscle relaxant, but, you know. You know what happened there. For anyone who doesn't, muscle relaxant used to give 350% damage up to, like, pretty much any weapon with rifle in its name. And then 450% damage up to a specific few weapons. I think it was sniper rifle and hexagon. But it's since been specifically nerfed. So now it only gives 50% damage up, and the range of guns is much more limited. Really hoping I just make it through there. Got him. Alright. Almost crushed myself there. Almost. We still haven't found an item room. Been on this floor for a very long time. Still no item room. Yeah, let's not throw the gun away, actually. I'm really glad there's no veteran rounds in this room, because circle strafing whilst dealing with the veteran rounds would just suck. I should refill the vertebrae because it looks like I might have to use that for the boss next floor. Well, thanks. I guess. I don't want to have to come back here. Alright, thank you. Health up is actually pretty good. Quite necessary for me currently. I should have completed the floor first just to guarantee that I wasn't going to run into a keyman store. But there was also no teleporter near the... near the chest up there, and I didn't really want to have to waste a half minute traversing the map to get back here. Okay. I don't really have the weapons for that, though. Can I buy the sniper? I can. Between sniper and vertebrae, we might be able to. Our health will definitely pull out through, right? And if we do this, we will win the game. So there's no way I'm not doing this, but I am terrified. So I've got to have vertebrae and then sniper rifle on the offhand. Vertebrae has to be for when they shoot out any projectiles, pretty much. Sniper rifle has to be for standard damage. Oh, that was a glitch chest, by the way, so now we fight the glitch bosses, just in case anyone's missed this. And it is two beholsters standing on top of one another. Okay, you don't want them to split up, or at least I don't. It's gonna make them a lot harder for me. We've only taken one damage to them so far. I'm actually quite proud of that. It's also worth noting this will be the entire floor, so I can blank with ease. Yep, ran out of ammunition on the gun like I thought I would, and now it's starting to take the real damage. But it's okay. We persevered. Okay, so you get a ridiculous amount of items for doing that, and a lot of them are super high tier. So, I'll be taking the prototype railgun, the Yari launcher, the demon head, the emperor, beholster, crescent crossbow, snake maker, directional pad... Seems good, man. Seems good. This should refill something good. Die. Alrighty then. One of the big reasons I wasn't really worried about my health, specifically with regards to going into this fight, as I quickly pick a gun to use, is that nanomachines was pretty certain to keep me healthy. Nanomachines being when you take damage, there's a chance that you generate a piece of armor. I don't know how many times it triggered in that fight, but if I went down a significant part of my health bar, I probably would have triggered it enough times. If I didn't have those two penetrative weapons, being... God damn it. Just gotta focus here for a second, because I don't want them encroaching on my space. If I didn't have those two penetrative weapons, being Vertebrae K-47 and the sniper rifle, I don't know if I would have been able to do that. Vertebrae K was clearly all I needed, but even if I only had Vertebrae K, I don't know if I would have signed up for it. Always glad to see a glitch chest, that said. Mech them into a snack. Beauty. Let's go check our shrine. Escape rope. No. We do have the ability to steal using D-pad, which is why I'm still holding on to it. The YV shrine is interesting. I don't know if I'll be able to use it. I also don't know if I'll be able to trigger it that many times. So I'll just hold on. In case you don't know what YV Shrine does, because it is actually quite rare. I'm gonna have to steal Reload Stone, in fact. But if I am gonna steal Reload Stone, I need to make sure I don't want to buy anything first. Because if I steal it with D-pad, it'll be noticed that I stole it. Okay, so the YV Shrine costs 10 times the... like, the number of your usage. So your first use costs 10, second use costs 20, etc., etc. And it gives you a 4% chance to double, triple, or quadruple any shot you shoot. So you trigger it a bunch of times, you trigger it, say, 4 times, you now have a 16% chance to trigger that double, tripling, or quadrupling of a shot. It is pretty good when your weapons don't already hit boss armor, and then it's... other than that, fine. Also, if your weapons don't one-shot enemies, because if your weapons one-shot enemies, I mean, firing two of them isn't really gonna help you. So doing it on a Mega Hand or a Heroin run doesn't really make that much sense. Good work, me. Yes, thank you. I'd really like to get down with using the Yari launcher a lot, but... oh, that's slightly off-center. Why are you off-center? Oh, no, you're normal. Alright then. It was just slightly askew for no other reason than no reason. The important thing to note here is our Runeclaw weapons are still kind of bad, but since we have so many... I don't mean bad. When I say bad, I don't mean bad, and I understand that can be confusing. What I mean is no one of them will get it through the entire game. Consider the fact that we've already had to pick up an ammo drop on this floor for using the Snake Maker. Something is not bad if it alone can't carry you through the game. I understand that. Don't worry. I'm saying that a lot of these weapons are fine for our room clear, just because we have so many of them. We've got Crescent Crossbow, we've got Hegemony Rifle, we've got Snake Maker, for example. Put them all together, and we will have the ability to brute force our way without any ammo drops through hell. Also, getting reload stone is going to be really, really good because it'll give us a passive, really fast reload for our weapons. Something that I actually really wanted after I fought the glitch chest was I really wanted to get Super Meat Gun. Specifically because Super Meat Gun is one of those guns that gives you a passive that is active even when you're not holding out that gun. I can't even think of many other guns that do it. I mean, Rad Gun and Smiley's Revolver and Shay's Revolver obviously have plus coolness, and lower store prices, respectively. But there's not that many that have that as a thing that they do. Like, for example, the Gungeon gives you higher speed, but only when you're holding the Gungeon out. I'm talking about the ones that give you a benefit that is still there even when you're not currently using that gun. And the Super Meat Gun gives you a speed up and a health up. That would have been really good to replace whatever passives I would have gotten on the floor that I didn't go to, as well as the Master Round I clearly wasn't going to get. I mean, this is good, but unless we suddenly get a huge synergy for this, I think we're still going to be going with the Reload Stone. Thank you. So that's two ammo drops to make this gun really viable for an entire floor. And here I thought that one was actually gonna hit. My bad. Okey-dokey. All settled. Now we can go back up to the store. I don't need to buy any keys, I will never need to buy ammo, so now I can just steal the Reload Stone. Yoink. Now you'll lock up shop, see how I can't purchase any of these. There's never going to be a scenario wherein I use directional pad as my weapon, so I may as well just spam it out. 2, 3... So I've got a 12% chance for that duplication to trigger. Duplication, triplication, quadruplication. Any of those. Let's make this a little shinier by starting to cast some of the fireballs. Woo! Getting a lot of fireballs to go in one direction is pretty good. That would be a lot of damage. But, you know, so would almost all of my other guns. Okay, health up. Thank you very much. I mean, I guess I can try and refill the Yari launcher using the Reload Stone. That could be interesting. What do I think is going to be the most dense the bullets get, though? Certainly not right now. You know the fucking annoying thing about that? I was trying to swap back to the Yari launcher so that I could start siphoning out of it. But I couldn't swap back to the Yari launcher because it was on my quick swap menu. But since it was empty, the game was like, no, you don't want to go to an empty weapon. I'll give you the next full weapon. Game, that is a quality of life mechanic that specifically worked against me in that circumstance. How dare you? All right, let's just use this to try and refill. I mean, it got a lot. Typically, the only reason that you don't one cycle on that is because of damage gating, and Yuri bypasses damage gating, so of course I wanted to use it. That's not enough to do anything on this floor. I can get rid of two weapons on this floor, so well. I'm actually probably not going to use Crescent Crossbow that often. I'm definitely not going to use Moonscraper, and it's a green tier weapon. And so is Science Cannon, so I'll actually just get rid of those. Crescent Crossbow is red, so I could go red and green, but whatever. Right. Bye, y'all. Fine. I actually like hammer. I think it's a fine weapon. So where is our room clear on this next floor? We don't have damage up, so we need to use a gun that has decent damage. I think I'm actually going to still chill with a Snake Maker. Super accurate. Decent clip size. Reload time is off the charts. Obviously. Thank you, reload time. My goal, actually, at the moment, is to complete this so quickly that people think that I died in the run. Because if you see, like, 40 minutes, and my typical run is, like, 55 to an hour, if you see 40 minutes, you're probably thinking, oh no, the streak ended. Surprise, motherfucker. We just got another glitch chest, yo. Especially with the duplications, we're getting a lot of snake making going on here, and I love it. Not what I intended at all. Respawns. This definitely goes in the Yuri. Because now I can just use the reload stone at will for my current gun. Rather than constantly hold off and go, yes, but what if I find a bunch of bullets? I can suck them up and put them in this gun. Or in the Yuri, rather. Waiting for a situation that will almost certainly never occur. It's also worth noting that you want to use this defensively as well. Because it is, effectively, invincibility for a while. In, at least, it prevents you from taking damage from bullets. Okay. There we go. Whee! Let's just hold off and wait for... There we go, that's the kind of enemy I was looking for. Now this is an enemy I can really make into a snake. God damn it. I only got 34 ammunition from that as well. I was certain I was gonna get more. Okay, this is my first branching three. This looks promising so far, but we all know how that can mislead. Now it looks like it was misleading me. But we all know how that can mislead, so we'll wait. Gonna take a billion shots to kill this guy, but I'm down to do them. No, 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 no. You come back here, bud. Yeah, this is starting to look like it's looping back. It definitely is. God damn it. It bamboozled me with that first one. Really thought this was gonna have enough knockback to knock things off the map, but didn't. See, I don't really get like a hit reception sound here, so making this a little more difficult. There we go. Alright. Come on, be a bullet heavy room. Not really. You just stay back there. I like that this is just gonna apply that constant pushback. And that we don't really have to be careful with our ammunition at all. Makes life so much easier when you realize, I mean, God, I have so many guns, just so many guns. My backups have backups. It's time! Absorb the bullets! Thank you! That was about 100 there, I liked it. In fact, it must have been more because I fired some off as well. I want to hit the transmogs rather than the kills here, because the transmogs will also prevent the spawning of the friendly friends? These little guys? The bullats? Okay. I do have some health scattered across the level, but having to rely on that is probably not the greatest plan. Good, and there's the ammo drop that I've been waiting for. So now we can just use Snake Maker until the rest of the game, and Yari Launcher against the boss. With opportune breaks to suck in some ammunition for it. That'll be really easy to do in the final phase. Second last phase? Not really, but final phase, definitely. And obviously the first phase will die before we really get a chance to. Hey, and we chose the correct path. Nice. I'm getting Snake Maker a lot recently, actually. Not that I'm displeased with it at all. I like the gun. It's just strange that I didn't see it for hundreds and hundreds of hours, and now it's just here, constantly. Hanging out all the time. Making itself at home. Using my coffee mug. What was I talking about? Best practices, I should still at least go and pick up these half healths. Even if I am 100% certain that I could pretty much just walk it in, I should still probably not do hugely stupid things that will definitely make me take damage. Alrighty then, 80 for round 2, and I've almost got the reload stone back.
Love it.
I do love me a good glitch chest run. That's another thing that's been happening more and more to me recently. I think I may have had like 2 glitch chests in the last 20 episodes. Which doesn't sound like a lot until you remember. It is the, like, those are the second and third that I've ever had. Remember, I can't quick swap back to an empty weapon. Can't quick swap back to an empty weapon. So I am gonna have to use something else for a while. Oh, obviously. This is exactly what I wanted. I didn't want to blank this because now we just go shopping. Hello! Thanks for the bullets, bud. Oh, baby. You're just making it too easy, Litchy Boy. What's that, Litchy Boy? You want the Millennium Idol? All right. That's another Lich down, 47 minutes flat. Thank you, Mr. Glitch Test. Mr. Glitch Chest. I don't know if I would have bought the sniper rifle if it wasn't for the glitch chest, and I definitely wouldn't have had as much ease throughout. I might have had another health container from flawlessing a boss. If it wasn't High Priest, it's quite likely I would have ended up with that. And of course, there would have been 2 more items, as well as another floor's worth of picking up different consumables. Who knows? May have been better, in fact, for me to have gone to the full holo rather than the glitch chest, but this was definitely more fun. My name has been Rhapsody, the name of the game has been Enter the Gungeon. Hopefully you've been enjoying yourselves, and hopefully we'll see you next time.